Good evening, audiophiles and music lovers. This is Lo again from Singapore. Today's topic, my ultimate advice for your next hi-fi system purchase. I'd like to share with you a very important tip to take note of whether you are going to buy your brand new hi-fi setup, that means CD player, amplifier and the speaker set, or just upgrade or new CD player, new amplifier or new speaker system. This is one important tip you have to take note of, right? But just prior to that, please click on this video clip. Please help me click on my like. It does help with the algorithms a little bit. I need that push to have me consistently posting on YouTube to share with you whatever I know, right? Until you will be better than me one day. And also, please comment. I would like your input to see area that I'm weak in, that I can improve, and also on topic that may interest you that I can share in my next video. And please also help me to share with your friend if you think they need some good advice, right? Come back to my ultimate advice on your hi-fi purchase. Be it new or used, right? In hi-fi, there is such a thing that we buy vintage ware that may be 10, 20, 30, 40 years old amplifier, especially those horn-loaded speakers. Yeah, they can be those from 50s or 60s and still in good condition to run music with. Presume all being equal, you are in a dealership to audition a pair of speakers. You intend to buy a new pair of speaker, use or upgrade whatever speaker that you have, right? While for a new couple, especially you have a new home, your wife won't mind you get a good sound system that both of you can enjoy in your loving years, right? In your home, sweet home. And of course, then you will have to allocate a certain budget. So you may be very new or a seasoned player in hi-fi, right? So you go to the dealership. All being constant, that means, let's say you want to compare a pair of speaker A, speaker B, and speaker C, different brand from the same dealership. All being equal, that means the CD player, the interconnect, the amplifier and cable to the speaker setup, all got to be the same. So then there is a basis of comparison. And then you test out speaker A, B and C, play through some music at normal listening volume. Right. And then most probably one speaker will be out. You may not like the sound coming out from that speaker. So let's say we presume we shortlist to A and B. So of course when you go to the dealership, will be within your budget, right? And you have the intention to purchase, and then you do some serious auditioning. Some bring their own CD players, if you're still into CD player, because now they're new formats. Okay, so now come to A and B, normal listening volume, everything sounds good, right? The real acid test, my ultimate advice: you play it at super low volume. It's still audible, still can hear. There's still music coming out from the both, let's say, presumed speaker A and B. You sit down there, you listen. That one that produces the highest possible mid and high, that will be the ideal speaker for you to purchase. Why I say that? We don't need to go into the technicalities of why. Right. So like now you notice, there are people who play their hi-fi system, especially for speakers. Then they add on a super tweeter and they add on horn to their speaker. Why? Because of this problem. If the original speaker can play music at low volume with good mid and good high, when you play in normal or a bit louder volume, the speaker is still able to sing. Like this is in layman term, we don't go into the technicalities, right? Because bass travel omnidirectional. The louder the volume, the bass somehow will overwhelm the mid and the high. and somehow it will drag down the high frequency of the music. That's why sometimes you don't get that feeling, like you just don't feel good that no, the music coming out is not singing to you, right? It's because the higher the volume, there will be distortion because of interference. The bass, the low frequency will pull down the overall music enjoyment, right? That is my today's ultimate advice for your next purchase, right? So please click on the link below. You can opt in into my email list, right? So I will do from time to time updates or video updates that you can get from me. Thank you.